Letting go. Why should we lean on the past? To be depressed all the time, tormented by bad memories? There is absolutely no reason to be living in the past. All this will do is make you that one person who is sad all the time for no reason. If you are going to be remembering something all the time, let it be something great that makes you a better person. You can't have a better tomorrow if you don't forget yesterday. I believe we should let the past go away and try to become better people for the future. It all started June 18, 2010, to be exact. It was a beautiful sunny Friday morning. I woke up early to give breakfast to my little 6-year-old cousin, Isabel. At about 1 p.m., I sent her out to her ballet class and said goodbye to my Aunt Loani, who was off to work. I watched TV for a while, when suddenly the international phone rang. I was very surprised, since we didn't usually get that many calls from the States. It was my Aunt Xiomara. She sounded miserable. She was crying and crying. I got scared. I didn't know what news to expect. Loani, is she alive? She screamed out in desperation. And that is when it hit me. I didn't know what to do or what to think. I just froze. I felt the sudden urge to cry. But inside me, there was still a little spark of hope that this was all just a joke. Beep, 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 the connection failed. My aunt never got to tell me what had happened. I tried for several minutes to recuperate the call with tears bursting out of my eyes. I felt like my tears burnt my face like acid. I lost all hopes towards the phone call, but didn't lose hope on my aunt's life. I mean, I got that little piece of information from someone out in Texas. Maybe they confused the person or something like that. I ran to my room and prayed as much as I could until I heard Isabel knocking on the door. I tried to clean up my face really fast. It would have been bad for me if she started asking all these questions which I didn't even know the answer to. Her father's family came by that afternoon to pick her up. At night, many of my family members came to my house with depressing faces. I kept asking everyone what was wrong, but they just hugged me and turned away. This was driving me insane. I couldn't stand all the mystery. Finally, my mom came and they sat my brother and me in the living room, surrounded by family. My mother stood strong, trying not to cry, and finding the courage to get it out of her mouth. Your Aunt Loani has passed away. She was murdered. I broke down and cried uncontrollably. Without a question, this was the most tragic time of my life. The cloudy day of my aunt's funeral, I was sitting right next to the coffin when Isabel came into the room carried by her grandmother, with the same face of worried confusion I had had the day before. Isabel slowly reached to the coffin's window and immediately turned away to cry in her grandmother's chest when she realized it was her mother. That moment has been imprinted in my mind. I remember every single little detail. After this hardship, my mother decided for us to move to Miami, to try and get away for a while, to let it all sink in. Several times, my mother and I would go to the mall and find shirts that looked similar to the ones my aunt owned, just shed into tears. I used to cry every single night for about 2 months straight. Constantly, I always remembered the bad moments. I just imagined the 13 bullets encrusted in her skin, impacting her body one by one. My little cousin being sent away to live with her careless father and mean stepmother. But one day, I decided to stop. All those hurtful moments weren't going to take me anywhere good in life. It was going to do was work my way toward depression. Then suddenly, it all fell back to the good memories I had with my aunt. Like when I was just a toddler and she took care of me, like I'd take care of Isabel. I remember me waiting for her all day. When she came from school, she would heat her food in the microwave and we would watch Art Attack together. She drew beautiful portraits and made sculptures. She was a great artist. I used to draw silly, ugly doodles back in the day. and I would proudly go up to her and show them. She would tell me they were beautiful, but there was always space for improvement. She was my first inspiration to do what I love, draw. From that one day that I decided to think back on the good things and try to forget the bad memories, I have turned into a different person, one that is smiling and happy all the time. I'm rather happy that I decided to have taken this step, because if I hadn't, who knows what kind of person I would have turned into. Each happiness of yesterday is a memory for tomorrow. We will all die one day, and we will always be remembered by someone. But the world goes on. My aunt will forever be in my heart as the great loving person she used to be. When we die, don't we want to be remembered by the good memories? We have to think about happy memories and try to forget the sorrowful moments in order to be a better person and lighten all those around you. In this, I truly believe.